Hello friends, welcome back to LearnItGuide tutorials. Thanks for watching this video. This is a sixth video of our OpenStack tutorial series. In this session, I am going to show you how to install and configure Glance OpenStack component for image services to our OpenStack project. So basically, Glance provides OpenStack image service, which allows us to store and retrieve virtual machine images. By default, image service directory is under /var/lib/glance/images. Server should have enough space to hold the images on your disk. Glance has a RESTful API that allows querying of VM image metadata as well as retrieval of the actual images. Related links are mentioned in the description below. Refer those links, that would be easier for you to understand this session much better from basics. This is our OpenStack architecture diagram, so we are planning to deploy 2-node OpenStack architecture. Even if you are trying to install Glance image service in a new machine, doesn't matter, you have to follow the same procedure. And this is a 2-node setup, hence we have splitted the components in this way. You can also have individual servers for each components, it's up to your requirement. So we have a 2-node. The first one is controller node, the second one is compute node. On controller node, we will be installing all this MariaDB for database, RabbitMQ for message service, Keystone identity service. These three we have already done. And in this session, I will be showing this Glance image service. In the next session, I will show you Nova for compute, Neutron for networking, and Horizon for our dashboard. Same time, on the compute node, we have done MariaDB database and we are painting with Nova and Neutron. So we will show you that while doing this Neutron and Nova on controller node. So we have already seen how to install and configure MariaDB, RabbitMQ and Keystone. So keep watching the video till the end. If you feel something I have missed or you wanted to know more about something else, please leave your comments in the comment section and subscribe our YouTube channel for more updates. And you are watching LearnItGuide tutorials. We provide you 100% free documents and tutorial videos to build your skills. For more updates, stay connected with us on social networking sites and subscribe our YouTube channel. Go to youtube.com and search for LearnItGuide tutorials. Hit subscribe button to not miss any updates. Click nearby bell icon to get notification immediately. Let's get started. Stages involved in this whole OpenStack deployments are enabling repository and installing OpenStack Liberty packages, and install and configure MariaDB database, which is required to install on all the nodes. Again, installing RabbitMQ and Keystone for identity service, and I'll be showing this Glance now. Later on, we'll see how to install Nova, Neutron and Horizon. These are the stages involved in this whole OpenStack deployments. Prerequisite is installed CentOS 7.164-bit on controller node and make sure each host are reachable and verify the internet connection, because we are using public repos to install these components, and take a backup or snapshot at different stages to restore in case of any failures, and disable SELinux and stop firewall to avoid issues during the installations. Also, you can enable it or you can allow each component services on firewall after the installations. So enabled OpenStack Liberty repositories and installed OpenStack Liberty packages already, and configured MariaDB database, because we need to have a separate database for each OpenStack components. For Glance also, we need to create a database on MariaDB. Again, we need to register the Glance with Keystone. Let's see how to do that. First, we need to create a database for Glance using this way. Get into the database using this command mysql-u root-p, and it will prompt you to enter the password. You have to enter the password of your database. After that, you have to create database of Glance and grant all privileges on this Glance at the red controller node one, as well as Glance from any host. Identify by the password Red Hat. Simple. And if your host name is different, something else, then you have to replace the controller node one with your server name and replace the password what you have set for the password of database. To get into the database, mysql-u root /p, and enter the database password. Create the database, create database clients, hit enter. Query OK, one row affected. Now we need to grant all the privileges. So this is the command to grant all the privileges on which database clients, to whom, who are accessing using this database clients at the right from this particular host, that is controller node 1. If they are giving the right password, Red Hat, this will allow. Hit enter. Again, grant all privileges, same, but here for any host, because later on you may install any OpenStack components in future, so it has to be, the database has to be accept your incoming connections. So hit enter. That's it. Now exit from this database. You have created the database for clients. So let's install the clients packages. So these are the packages required for clients: OpenStack clients, Python clients, Python clients client. That's it. Hit enter. So the installation is completed. Now we need to configure the clients image services like this. In the previous videos, I have shown you there are two ways to configure it: by directly editing the configuration file or using OpenStack-config command. So in this, I'm going to use VI to edit the configuration file. So there are two configuration file for clients, which is etc clients clients api.conf as well as clients-registry-conf. Here on these both the files you have to make the changes, except few. I will tell you that. So first thing, you have to mention the database properly under the section database parameter connection equal to MySQL clients colon Red Hat at the rate on which node controller node 1, the database name is clients. So according your settings, you have to change the database name, password and the node name. Now under the section Keystone Auth token as well as paste deploy, you have to change these values. Let's see how to do that. Here, search for database. And here, just make an entry for the connection like this. Now, search for Keystone Auth token. So here the URL and URL are pointing to controller node 1 with the port 5000 and 35357, and just make the changes like this and search for paste deploy. Here just make the changes for the parameter flavor equal to Keystone. Again search for default section. Here just make a entry notification driver equal to noop, and now search for clients store. Here we need to make the changes like this to define default store file format and location data directory should be var lib clients images. That's it. Just save and exit from here. Now we need to make the changes on clients registry file. Just open it and make the changes as you have made in the clients API configuration file, except the clients store parameters. That's it. Just save and exit from here. I have done the same parameter changes except the clients store. Just save and exit from here. Now we need to populate the clients image services using the command su-s bin sh -c clients manage database sync and the database name clients. You can just ignore it if you get this kind of warning. Now we need to start the service OpenStack Glance API. Here we have a two service. One is for Glance API and other one is for Glance registry. First start for API. Now start for registry. Now enable it for API, then enable it for registry. Now we need to create a client environment scripts for the project admin. So we have created the project called admin and we have not yet created demo project, it's optional. And why do we create client environment scripts? Means these scripts to load appropriate credential for client operations. So just create a file something like this admin-openrc.sh and load all the credentials. Project admin name, project domain name, let it be default, user domain name default, project name admin and username admin. These are the settings already we have designed as per our OpenStack deployment. And auth URL, this is the auth URL, and APO version 3 and APO version of image is 2. So just create a file with this value and source the admin-openrc.sh to load the environment to gain the access. Let me show you that. So this is how you have to make the changes. So just replace with your project name. If you are creating a project something called PayPal for OpenStack, then you have to change accordingly and same username and password. So I have created the username called admin and I have set the password called admin. So not a matter for me, I just save and exit from here and just load it. To gain the access. Now we need to create the Glance user and we need to add the roles for the Glance user. So you know how to do that because already we have seen how to do that on Keystone. So now we'll do the same for Glance user as well. So this is the command OpenStack. What you are going to create for user, create and domain, let it be default and password prompt. So it will prompt you to enter the password for Glance user. So after that we'll add the admin role to the Glance user and service project. So this is how you need to add the role. And finally we have to create the Glance service entity. So this is a command to create and it will prompt you to enter the password for Glance. It's done. So I have given the password Glance only. Now we need to add the role. The project name is service, user Glance and admin. So we have added the role for the Glance user called admin. Now create the Glance service entity using this command. OpenStack service create name Glance and what is the description of it? OpenStack image services and function is image. Just hit enter. Now you got the value, which means it is created. Now we need to create the image service API endpoints. The one is, first one is for public, the region is region 1, the second one is for internal, same region, and the last one is for admin, same region. But these are the APIs and it has to be do in the same way for all the OpenStack components. If not, your OpenStack component will not work properly. So far we have done for public and internet. So the last one is admin. So we have created the endpoints. The last thing is we need to test the configuration. So to test the configuration, you should have some ISO image on your server. So for this demo, normally I have downloaded the list size image and I have kept it in my root folder so that we can upload the image to the image service using QCOW2 disk format or bag container format and public visibility so all projects can access it. So here we use only the Cirar ISO image because it is quite smaller size, so that's easy for us to download and use it. So already I have downloaded using wget, and this is a path. You can download any ISO image and just keep it in your location. Now we are going to upload the downloaded image to the Glance image service, and this is the command to upload it. Once you are uploaded, now you have to execute the command Glance image list. So this will list you all the images are available with your Glance image services. Even you can upload your CentOS image, RHEL image, OpenSUSE, whatever image you have, you can upload it to Glance, and you can list the images using this command Glance image list if everything is okay. So this is my image file, what I have downloaded before using wget. Restarted the OpenStack Glance API and OpenStack Glance registry services because we have done so many changes after populating the Glance image services. Now I have run the command to upload my downloaded ISO image of Cirar OS using the command OpenStack image create the name of that image Ciras and the file name of the downloaded ISO image, the exact path. Now I'm in the directory where I'm in, so I have not given any path. And the format of test should be QCOW2, and container format should be bare metal and --- public. That's it. I have hit enter, so I got the output of something like this, and this will tell you the information about that Cirar OS. Now if you wanted to list the images of your Glance server, so this is the command to list the images. So this will give you the list of images available on your Glance image service. Currently we have only one ISO image, that is, this is the ID and the name of that is Cirar, what we have given over here. So our Glance image service is working perfectly. So this is how we need to install and configure Glance image service for OpenStack. In the next session we will see how to configure other OpenStack components. So keep practicing and have fun. How did you feel? Is it helpful? Appreciate our efforts in the comment section below. Hit like button, share with your friends about us, subscribe our channel to get further updates. Stay connected with us on social networking sites. For more free tutorials, visit our website www.lanityguide.net.